हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ केतन बावसर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन एलजी इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अहमदाबाद। इन टुडे सेशन वी डिस्कस अबाउट फंक्शन आईएसआर एंड टास्क फ्रॉम इंटर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन इन एम्बेडेड सिस्टम। सो नाउ जस्ट गो अहेड एंड वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज फंक्शन आईएसआर एंड टास्क, बिकॉज इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द टास्क एंड टास्क स्टेट। सो व्हाट इज द टास्क? टास्क इज वी कैन सी दैट इट्स अ स्मॉल प्रोसेस। So the task is a small process, right? So now to understand the concept of task, function and ISR, the first of all we go with a function. Now what is function? The function is an entity used in any program, function, task or thread for performing a specific set of actions. When call and on finishing the action, the control returns to the function calling entity. A calling function or the task or the process or a threads. So function is an entity used in any program. It is an entity. Entity means what? It is a declaration part of input and output. It is a declaration of the variable. It is declaration of the small functions, global variables or etc. Fine. Each function have that own ID, means a specific ID number. Program counter for executing the task, because in previous session we already see what is a program counter. Program counter is really used to continuously counting the execution of a task. It's a stack which saves when it called another function for the stack store or return to the caller. The function can be nested, so it can be nested and non-nested. Nested means it is connected with the one other function, means one function can call the another function and the call another function will call the another function and so on processes. Later it returns into the reverse order. So basically it will continuously process if you're talking about the nested side. Interrupt service routine mechanism. Now what is interrupt service routine mechanism? If you're talking about the interrupt service routine mechanism part, so the ISR is the function is called is an interrupt from an interrupt servicing code. Further, unlike the function, the ISR can have the hardware and software assigning properties, means it can be called directly hardware and software part. And further, unlike the function, the ISR can have the mask which inhibit the execution on the event when the mask is set and enable the execution when the mask is reset. So basically it will calling the function of the different number of task. So basically, if you're talking about the function, then ultimately we're talking about one function we'll call the another function. In terms of the ISR, it is an interrupt service mechanism. Means if you execute any task, then it will provide the different types of stacks, holds on the particular running of the task. Now, what is task? Because as I already told you, we already discussed in the previous session. In terms of the task, its task is defined as execution of the computational unit. It is really used to provide a different types of access to the task for performing some specific operation. So task is defined as the execution of the computational unit that process on the CPU and state on which it is under the control of kernel of an operating system. Now user. Now if you see the difference in terms of the user side, then how we can differentiate the concept of task? So as you can see, the function ISR and task, a function for running the specific set of codes for performing the specific set of actions as per the argument passes to it. So basically the function is used for running the specific set of codes for performing the specific set of actions as per the argument passes to it. In terms of the ISR, for running on an event specific set of codes for performing the specific set of actions for serving the interrupt calls. If you're talking about the interrupt calls, then it directly call with the ISR function as a user side. Task, for running the codes on and context switching to it by the OS, and the codes can be in terms of the endless loop for the event as. So basically it can be directly controlled with help of the event based task. So we have a see that the uses of functions ISR and task. Now calling sources, if you're talking about the calling sources, then how it will be helpful. For calling the function, the call from another function or the process or thread or the task. In terms of the ISR, it's an interrupt call for running the ISR can be from the hardware or software at any instant. A task, a call to run the task is from the system in terms of the RTOS. So RTOS can let another higher priority task execution after the blocking of the present one. It is the RTOS, because as I already told you, in terms of the RTOS, it stands for the real-time operating system. So main objective of the RTOS is that to provide a specific task of operation, means it will execute any task or any specific task on given amount of time, because it's a real-time operating system. So based on the priority, it will hold the previous one and execute a higher priority task. Context switching. In terms of the functions run by change in program counter instantaneous value, there is a stack on the top of which the program counter value for the code or left without running and the another value saves. So all the functions have the common stack in order to support the nesting. So each and every time we are talking about the nested switching. So as you can see, if you're talking about the program counter or nested function, so here you can see that on the x-axis we are talking about the time and y-axis we are talking about the program counter. So code in memory running using the PC. We have a function of function 1, function 2 or function 3 in terms of the function f, f1 and f2. If you're calling the function f1, once it will be executed, then it will be going to the function f2. One, it will execute the function f2, then and only then it will return to the function f1 and then return to function f with respect to time. So in terms of the nested, we have to call in the one another function of the simultaneous value. Now common stack and nested function, as you can see that in terms of the common stack and nested function, you have a function f, call the function f1. Now save the context of function f, run the function f1, then call the function f2, save the context of f1, then again run the function f2. So basically you can see that the function f, f1 and f2, once f1 run, then context saves in function f. When f2 run, then context are saving function f1. Now context saving for the ISR. Each ISR is an event driven function code. So the code run by the enhancing the program counter instantaneous value. So ISR have a stack for the program counter instantaneous value and the other value that must be saved. So all the ISR can have a common stack in case of the operating system support. Now we are talking about the task. Each task has a distinct task stack at a distinct memory block for the context in terms of the program counter that must save. So each task has a distinct process structure, means in terms of the TCB to provide a distinct types of memory management in terms of the task control block. Now similarly you can say that the concept of task and their separate context, so task A, task B, task C. Suppose we have only two tasks, task A and task B. So as you can see that the stack of task A and the context of task A. Now if we will switch to the task B, it will wait for the task pointer, it will save the context of task A. Now it will wait for the load the context of task B, and again according to that the stack pointer will be updated. Now it will go into the switch to task B and then it will execute the task B. So basically here you can see that the task A and task B. Task A and task B. Once the task A bit will be executed, at the same time it will be updated with the stack pointer. After that loads the value of context B, then it will be again execute the task B and then stack of B on context of B and the stack of A in context of A. So ultimately we have to start with the stack of A and stack of B at the ending side. Now response and synchronization. If you're talking about the response and synchronization, means what we are talking about the synchronization. We're talking about the timing based concept. Function is a nested of the another function. So hardware mechanism for specific instantaneous mode synchronization between the function directly without control the scheduler off or OS. So basically we can directly operate monitoring the data without requirement of the any scheduling mechanism. In terms of the ISR, the hardware mechanism for responding to an interrupt for the interrupt source cell and according to the given OS kernel feature synchronization mechanism for the ISR that can nested the supported by the OS. Similarly, if you're talking about the task, so according to the given OS kernel feature, there is a task responding and the synchronization mechanism. The kernel function are used for the task synchronization because only the OS kernel call the task it to run at a time. So basically if you're talking about the response and synchronization, then ultimately we are talking about the function ISR and task. Now structure, if you're talking about the structure of function ISR and task, the function can be a submitted of a purpose or a thread or the task or the ISR or the submit of the another function. So it's called as a function. In terms of the ISR, can be considered as a function which run on an event at the interrupting source. pending interrupt is scheduled to the run using the interrupt handling mechanism in that OS, and the mechanism can be priority based on the scheduling based concept. So basically, based on the scheduling mechanism, we can directly call and operate the ISR functions or ISR structure. So during the running of the ISR can let the another higher priority of ISR will run, because as I already told you, based on the priority we have to choose a specific ISR mode. Task is an independent and can be considered as a function which is called to run by the OS scheduler using the context switching and the task scheduling mechanism of the OS. So the system during the running of the task can let the another higher priority task run. So the kernel managing the task scheduling concept. Global variable use. Now global variable means what? There are the two types of variable, local variable and global variable. If we're talking about a global variable means what? Once we are directly assigning the task, it will continuously operate it. It will continuously monitor. It will continuously execute it. So basically that type of concept we can say that a global variable. Means once you are assigning a global variable means it is continuously assigned to each and every function or each and every loop or each and every task or each and every process. Now we see the global variable used for the function. Can change the global variable, the interrupt must be disabled, and after finishing the use of global variable, the interrupt are enabled. Means you can use an interrupt, you can use a global variable, you have to disable the interrupt, then enable the interrupt. Similarly for the ISR, when using the global variable in it, the interrupt must be disabled, and after finishing the use of global variable, the interrupt are enabled in terms of the analogous value or the functional value. Task, when using the global variable, either the interrupt are disabled and after finishing the use of global variable, the interrupt are enabled, or use of the semaphores or the lock function in critical sections which can use a global variable and memory buffers. So now if you're talking about the semaphores and lock variable, semaphore means what? We see in the next session, the semaphores means what? It is provided synchronization of the task. Suppose OS have a number of tasks, then that particular task will be operated manageable with help of a semaphore, because semaphores play a main role to provide different types of operating mechanism. Posting and scheduling parameters. Functions can get the parameters or messages through the argument is passed through it, and global variable that refer to which are made by it. So function run the results on the operating system. Now ISR, using the ISR means IPC functions can send the signal, token or message. So ISR can't use the mutex protections of the critical section by wait for the signals, a token or the messages. Task can send the signals and messages, can wait for the signal and message using the IPC function. So can use the mutex or the lock protections of the code sections by wait for the token or the lock at the section beginning, and the message is the post to take the unlock at the section end. So I hope that you are getting the idea what exactly I'm trying to convey in terms of a function ISR, and also we are talking about a task, because task we already discussed in the previous session. We see the difference in terms of you can see that in terms of uses, calling sources, context switching types. Now we can understand the concept of nested functions. Similarly for the nested function in terms of calling, context saving. Now response and synchronization. Similarly we are talking about the structure of functions, task and ISR. Similarly we are talking about the global variable, then how you can use the global variable in function, ISR and task with help of the interrupt enable or disable concept. Then posting and sending the parameters in terms of the functions, ISR and task means how you can send the data, how you can receive the data. So I hope that you are getting the idea about the function, ISR and task. If you have any doubt which is related to the function, ISR and task, you can feel free to contact me. So thank you for watching.